Hi, I was thinking I should continue to tell the story about what happened in 2010 when shit hit the fan, so to speak, and go a little bit further and explain the actual media events. So these murders that I got dragged into the murder story. The actual murders happened in January 2009, and then there was a time period of 15 months where there was where I was writing letters to this crazy mass murderer in Belgium because I was convinced that I had met him and that he had been reading my blog. So that's where we start today. And then in 2000, I will explain the letters further, how I, started to write the letters and what was in the letters, and et cetera, but I'm going to focus on the media events today. And so the killings were in January 2009, and in April 2010, 15 months later, the Belgium media decided that they had found out about the letters, they had read my blog, et cetera. They decided that they should out me in the media, in the press, and they did that. There was like huge news all over the Belgium television, and every newspaper wrote about it. And they wrote that his name is Kim de Kelder, this crazy mass murderer from Belgium. They called him also the Joker because they thought he looked like the Joker. And they wrote about me that he had a Swedish admirer that had, at first they wrote that I had told him to commit these murders, that I had talked him into doing this, that this was my request for my birthday. Because I had written on my blog on the same day he committed the first murders that I had wished for death on my birthday. So this was why I thought that he was the same person that I had met, and that I was then convinced that he had been reading my blog. So they so the Belgian media, they sort of followed my line in that aspect, that I had told them this and they brought it into the light. And I just wanted to know if it was the truth, if he had actually did that because of me, because something I had said or done that had caused this person to do that. So and when they started writing, it was all over the news, everywhere in Belgium. Every newspaper wrote about it. In the television, the Prime Minister of Belgium even went out and held a press conference and told people that I was not involved in the murders. I was not. Had had no contact with Kim de Kelder before the murders, and they also said that the Swedish police had questioned me, which they hadn't at the time, but they did that later. They didn't have my phone number, the Belgium journalists, so they found every phone number they could that was sort of related to me. They called my son's dad, for example, called their household. For several days, the phone was ringing and they went crazy, and other people that they knew could possibly know about me, they started calling. And finally, they got hold of my number, and and they emailed me, of course, and they wanted an interview. And so I started negotiating with the newspapers, because I caught up with events really fast, and I immediately started thinking, this is my rescue. This is, I can use this. Because you know what a dark place I was in before. So this was like, finally, somebody is listening to what I'm saying. Finally, they want to talk to me. They want to know what's going on. So this was my rescue. And I started negotiating about money, of course, because I'm not completely stupid. I know that the media would pay for an interview with me at that point, which they did. And that's also where the local media in the town I was living in, I think that's also a part of why they wrote that completely false story about that I had threatened the local kindergarten, because they were upset that I did not give them an interview for free, so they could in turn sell it to the Belgium media and make money. That they was, they thought they could, you know, rob me of my money. So there's a lot of intrigues involved in all the events that happened back then. And then when I got involved with the Belgian media, they came and came to my town first and made an interview from my home. Well, first there was like email interviews and phone interviews, and then they came to my home and did a longer TV interview for the TV. And then I traveled down to Belgium and participated in a talk show in front of a live audience and everything. And for me, this was I met them like not just halfway, but I just like, I embraced the role they wanted me to have, but also incorporated, you can say I met them halfway. Like I gave my side of the story, but I also incorporated what they wanted me to be, the role they wanted for the media. So it was like an acting job almost, that I was, I went into the character of who they wanted me to be, but tried to bring out the message of what actually brought me to do this and so on. I was trying to be as honest as possible, but also bring in like psychological and philosophical aspects to the whole story. And so that was that, and that was what happened in media, and I got involved in that, and I enjoyed it a lot. I thought, this is great. As I said, this is my rescue from the hellhole I was in at the moment. And it's not that I in any way lacked empathy for the victims and didn't feel for them, because if I hadn't, I wouldn't be shocked, I wouldn't have reacted, I would have ignored the event if I hadn't cared at all. So That was the media events, and is there anything more I can add to that? Well, I'm sure there is, but I will think about it later. But that was what happened. I used the media attention to for my own benefit.